So, you've just picked up the game, you've just arrived on Mars, and now you want to know the ins and outs of how to survive on the Red Planet. Now, first of all, there is a lot of things in the game that aren't straightforward right off the bat, and we're going to be talking about five of these today. We're going to be learning about some things that are not clear at all, but are very useful for a new player. So, you've just arrived on Mars with your first ship. You got three probes, a bunch of explorers, a couple of drones, and whatnot. Let's take a look here and just start scanning. It doesn't appear that we found any water. Should we deal with this? Of course not. What we can do is, if we have more than one rocket, we can just get another cargo rocket and get a bunch more orbital probes and whatnot. Also, hell, let's get another drone hub in there. Or a bunch of other stuff, and just launch it immediately whilst the other spacecraft stays in orbit. There is no real reason to take it down if you do not have a optimal landing spot available right away. Bring in an additional spacecraft. It will come from Earth, it will have the drones that you need, it will have the orbital probes that you will need, and you can land both spacecraft in unison and basically survey from there on, and maybe get a better landing spot. So, you have just arrived on the Red Planet, you've got your initial stuff online, but you realize you need more water, and that is perfectly fine. However, once we look at the map, we realize that there is not a lot of water nearby, and moisture evaporators don't necessarily do the job, especially if you are on a map with a lot of cold waste. Thankfully, we have got one little blob of water right here. However, it's not always very clear. You don't necessarily need to put one extractor on there. You can put multiples up there, all the way up to six, and they will all have the same amount of output, and they will all work in the same way. We can, for instance, go down here where there is another one, put a water extractor up here, put another one right there, put another one just surrounding it, and all six of these will all operate in unison and drain these resources. Very nice to have, and not particularly clear. Growth is always an issue, and the first dome, the basic dome, is not exactly great. It does not have a lot of space, and it does not allow for a lot of expansion possibilities. Therefore, I highly recommend that you try to skip that particular dome and go straight for low G engineering if you can, and just skip straight towards medium domes instead that have more than enough space to basically support any burgeoning little colony. Thankfully, one of the sponsors, India, starts with these, and also have a bunch more applicants available as well, ready to handle large amounts of population. The basic dome? It's garbage. Get yourself a medium dome. It's a lot bigger. It fits more people. So here is one that is not necessarily completely obvious, and I don't blame you. If you go into any of the buildings, there is this button to salvage the building. Makes perfect sense. However, if we go to any of the infrastructure lines, that is clearly not the case, as we cannot select them in any way. There is a button hidden inside the menus that allows us to remove these. And like I said, it's not particularly straightforward, but the salvage button, as it would imply, would, I don't know, usually mean that you just can salvage any building. But it turns out that the salvage button also works on any sort of infrastructure lines, which is incredibly useful. Sadly, it's not very clear that it also functions this way. So now you know, and you don't necessarily always have to go ridiculous amounts of infrastructure streamlining like I've done here in order to deal with your pipes and your power cables. So if you go into your tech window and you see these buttons that say, hey, you can optimize your factory by using factory AI, normally you could say, yeah, this is an automatic upgrade. You automatically get this applied to your factories, right? No, it is not. Because with any sort of building in the game, there is a cost attached to it. However, the upgrades do not list this on the tech window. So if we actually go into one of our buildings, for instance, let's say these here tech factories, you will see there's a button on the top right here, which improves the building. Obviously, you need to apply resources, and they need to get built over time. It's not very clear that it's there, but don't fall into the assumption that once you've researched something, like I said, in this particular case, the factory upgrade, that it's automatically applied. You still need to attach the upgrade to the building through these buttons. So there you have it. Those were a bunch of tips for beginners that are not particularly straightforward, but are still very important when it comes to making your colony a success. Good luck out there, Duster. If you liked this video, then make sure that you give it a like and or subscribe. We're going to try to get more Surviving Mars content up and running. And of course, we got Stellaris as well. As always, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, take good care of yourselves and each other.